Please be ready for a dictation of exercise number 19 from October 2021 issue of the Progressive Magazine. 5 seconds. Start. I am glad that I have been asked to lead our discussions on energy issues. As a developing country, it is a question of vital concern to us in India, both for our rural population and our industries. Each country has its own energy perspective and must develop those sources of energy where it can derive the best results, not just in terms of immediate profit, but in the long-term interests of its people. Conditions of every country, availability of basic sources of energy and capability will determine its choice of the technology of energy. When coal and oil begin to be used as motive power for industry and transport, there was a great transformation which brought forth both prosperity and poverty on a scale hitherto unknown to man. Coal and later oil fueled the age of machine. Oil began to replace coal because of its cheapness and superior utility, its cheap price and assured supply lulled the industrial world into a sense of complacency, with the result that despite the known limited period of exhaustion, no efforts were made to study alternatives. The world suddenly awakened with a shock to find that these treasures are finite and that they could be very expensive. In fact, it is quite safe to presume that even the current prices would hold good for more than a short period. Consequently, we have all to become conservatives or conservationists, if you like, and the wasting spree has to come to an end. It is certain that if we go on burning up the fossil fuel like this, the lights will go out everywhere much sooner than expected. Is it for such a fate of chilly darkness that human intelligence has striven all these centuries progressively to a happier state of living? What avails it if man, in an attempt to exploit nature, should be vanquished by his own folly of extravagance? This wisdom, which has dawned on us, was prefigured in our own country. Gandhiji tried to put across to his countrymen that man should not become a slave to the machine and victim of the machine age. He wanted us to develop an integral personality in communion with the environment and with fellow men. Advanced countries have now begun to see how dangerous it is to measure progress in terms of energy consumption per capita. We must correct such concepts and replace them. We cannot, of course, reverse the clock of development in modern age. Pollution is one of the worst of them, and the sources of energy has to be so chosen that the evils of pollution and degradation of environment are reduced to the minimum. We have a fairly abundant reserve of coal, but coal is also exhaustible and has to be exploited in an efficient way, including lower grades of coal and lignite. The pollution would also have to be seriously tackled. Hydroelectric power is the next most important and promising source of energy, not only for India, but for other countries as well. What is better still is that with hydropower, the risk of pollution is neither so strong nor unmanageable. We should systematically survey our hydropower potential and cooperate with neighbors to tap it for mutual benefit. Unlike oil, hydropower comes ever fresh and endless from the snow mountains and rain-fed rivers. To tap this fully in South Asia is a challenge to both engineering and fellowship. Modern science has opened up the atom and released its power for use by man. Nuclear power be harnessed for electricity, but there are well-known difficulties which have not been fully resolved as yet, notably the proper reactor and the disposal of waste. Two other sources of energy must claim our attention: biogas and solar energy. The advantage of using biogas plants in the villages is that it fits in with the technology of rural areas. There are, I believe, some problems yet resolved before it can be popularized in a large way to help the smaller peasants. In India, we are trying to work a strategy of community biogas plants. This is one energy sources which would be relevant to conditions in small countries as well as large ones, in towns as well as in villages. Large concentration of cattle population in villages and dairies particularly lend themselves to exploitation of this source of domestic use and small power requirements. It also provides a good opportunity for regional technical cooperation amongst countries. Solar energy is already beginning to be applied to a number of purposes, such as improved drying of agricultural produce, pumping water, desalination, heating, and air conditioning. Many countries are carrying on research into the application of solar energy. All our countries are blessed with abundant sunlight, and we should therefore have a primary interest in speeding up the commercial development of practical appliances using solar energy. India recently hosted a conference on solar energy, and we were gratified by the interest it generated. Here also, immediate prospects are good. Stop.